Hi, Othman. How are you? Thank you for joining us today for this 154 online review. For the people who don't know you, you're the president of MACAAL, a museum that is dedicated contemporary African art in Morocco, in Marrakech, to be exact. And you've been also one of the people who I know have visited quite often. 154 editions in London and in Marrakech. So for me, it was important to get your opinion and get your highlights of this digital online version of 154 New York. So I'm going to let you share with us your highlights and your coup de cœur of this edition. And we're ready for you.
Thank you, Turia. So many of the works that are exhibited on the platform are already in MACAAL's collection, thanks to 154. But I mean, I try to only pick the ones that really stood out to me, and they are not in the collection that I might be interested in buying. So this is what I like about 154. I think you guys always made us discover new artists and galleries, especially in this edition. So I'll start with Dominic Chambers, with the Luce Gallery. I discovered his work previously at 154 London, and I was very interested in this in his series of portraits. And I really, really like this new body of work. I think it's very special. I'm more and more myself interested in figurative painting and domestic scenes. And this work is a moment of meditation, and I find it very peacefully, especially in these times. I've bought a Caitlin Cherry through Luce Gallery, and I really, really like their program. That's why I'm gonna jump on the second artist that I've picked, which is February James in the same gallery. So February James is an LA-based artist. What I liked I like about her is she's an autodidactic artist. She the approach of her portrait are very special because she's always uses this very strong features and blurry faces, and also the color palettes that she uses. I think the expressions means a lot to me because they're playful but also very sad sometimes, and I love that. It's passing some emotions, and you know, in the contemporary world where everyone is trying to do the same, she really stands out.
Yeah, I agree.
In a completely total register, I really like Nabeeha Mohamed. This is a real discovery for me. She's with the Nuweland Gallery. I've picked this one, but all of them are very interesting. I think she is a Cape Town artist, a South African artist, and I'm obsessed with everyday life paintings. And this one is absolutely stunning. I love the bright colors. I love that it's popped. I love that it's very feminine. I love that it's also very random, when you have like a blue high heel, a lemon, a banana. All the paintings of all the artists are working to kind of highlight social issues, and this is a very, very interesting way of saying no to that. And I love that. I love also the very intimate size of the frames, and this is definitely something I could consider buying for my collection.
And what's nice is that it's quite new for 154 as well. It's a new gallery and an artist we never had before.
Yeah, and I like the fact that you're also shifting to a very young and emerging scene, more than what you have. Like, that was very specific and well curated. I love that. So Sulger-Buel Gallery have Slimen El Kamel as usual. I love Slimen. I collect Slimen, and I've been following his work for a couple of years. He's a very interesting artist. He's North African, he's Tunisian, and his works are very poetic, so very elegant. They are sometimes a symbol of my North African culture and heritage. And I love when you zoom in, you also have these very detailed paintings. It's very sad that we can't see the frame, but usually his frames are also sculptured. And I like that it's very childish and dreamy. And I love sometimes you find text, you find constellations. So yeah, he's a very interesting artist, and I'm gonna follow more on that. Mm. So I have Safaa Erruas in the same North African movement. Safaa Erruas, which is one of the most talented artists in Morocco, I know. She is from the north of Morocco. She has she always uses this very minimalist approach to art. The color, which is she uses the white. White is purity, is a symbol of peace. And I don't know if I'm going to try to zoom in without making any incident.
Yeah, but it's perfect. We
see it you can see perfectly how detailed this compositions can be. So this is a collage and also a drawing. And I like the fact that it's sometimes you can feel it's very fragile, even if the subject is very strong.
The zoom on Artsy, it's really good. I mean, we can see the details of the work, because usually I would say that Safaa, you really need to see it physically, because the amount of detail is unbelievable.
It is a very delicate, she uses always very delicate forms. She shows something that I'm trying to as well fight at MACAAL, is the position of the woman in society. And I think as a Moroccan woman, contemporary artist and an art activist, she's probably one of the highlights of my generation. So I'm gonna go on Larry Amponsah. Amponsah Larry, I've had the chance to meet him in 154 in London. He is with 50 Golborne as well as Safaa Erruas. I really like the program. I think this artist, he's very interesting. I was about to buy the blue one that was absolutely stunning in the 154 London edition. So his work is a multi-layered work. I'm going to zoom in so maybe you can see what I'm saying. So there, he makes this collage made of images, archives, and paintings. He also uses sometimes objects that he just put on the works. The titles are always very, very interesting, very poetic, very strong. He is Ghanaian, I think. I'm just going to go back. He's a Ghanaian artist, and he is at the premises of his career, but I think he's in a good path.
Yeah.
So I remember he was telling me about his approach of history and social issues, and I think this is something that we at MACAAL try to always raise and engage with. So he's a very interesting artist, and she is with AFRONOVA, this is also very sad. We also had a very sad news this weekend about Henri Vergon.
Yes.
So this is a very small homage, and I'm sending all my thoughts to Emily and his family. And I'm sorry, Toria, as well. I know you guys were very close.
I have to say it was one of the saddest news we learned this weekend as well. And he also participated so many edition of 154. I think it's one of our oldest, galleries and friends. So I think, as you have discovered, a lot of artists through him. So I'm glad that you made that choice. But once again, you know, it's like choosing an artist that I personally did not know before. So it's
same. Again, he made me discover Lebohan Cagnier, and now I'm discovering this wonderful artist. I mean, you know the love I have for photography. She's a very strong photographer. Her work is based on sex workers, I think, and and I've just done a bit of research, and I think the whole, of course, the approach of a photographer is always to highlight something, some issues in the society, but she documents social issues very strongly, and she's a very young, and I think being young in this environment is also giving you a way of seeing things differently. I love the light. I love that in this photo, for example, you can feel it very intense, and she's a great photographer, and I put her on my radar for sure. I went online to find other works from the artist, and of course you can see how beautiful the faces and the light is. She made this whole document and series on the sex workers, and it's exactly like this work I've seen from I forgot the name of the artist. But
Nombuso. Are you talking about another artist or the one?
Another artist. Yeah. I've seen, and I love the fact that their work is quite similar, and I might have them one day work together on a project. It gave me a lot of ideas. Thanks to Henry Starr as well.
Amazing.
For making this happen.
No, amazing, and I wish, you know, we're going to continue with Emily and Afronova to discover other talented young photographers, and it's such a loss. But listen, thank you for those highlights. This is amazing. Is it possible to share a bit of your experience on this digital versus physical experience, and how did you find, you know, navigating the fair, you know, online this year, and because of the circumstances?
I mean, to be honest, nothing beats a physical fair, huh? But I mean, as a collector and being a collector and traveling for art, going to fairs, sometimes it's also good to kind of browse from home in peace, and take time to research on the artist and to. But I mean, of course, I'm still missing engaging with galleries, discussing with artists, and meet with all my community and like-minded people. And this is why I always try to not miss 154 in London, because it's important for me to kind of be updated on what's new in the contemporary African world, and also meet with curators, with the artists, and understand the ecosystem, starting with the forum that you guys are organizing. So I think physical is definitely beating the online. Even though I have to say, I really enjoyed going through the website, it's good for people that cannot travel, and it's a good substitute. But I think technology should be used as a tool and not as a main subject. So yeah, I like as well the fact that it's very transparent with the prices, and you don't have to contact galleries. And it was very fun and didactic. So yeah, I have to say I look forward for the October 154 fair.
We all are, but it's as you say, it's a good substitute, and I think it gives an opportunity to get to get the work seen, you know, at a time like this, and we don't know what will be exactly the situation in a couple of months. Maybe some people would not be able to travel, so I think it's still very important. Yeah. But thank you, Othman, for joining us. I really appreciate you giving us your time and sharing your views and highlights. And I hope we'll be able to see each other very soon, physically. Maybe at 154, maybe in Morocco, wherever we have a chance to meet.
Yeah, hopefully soon. I mean, thank you for your time, Toria. And see you soon.
Thank you. Bye.